Your attention, please. The disclaimer and background sounds for the Price is Right pricing and recap for this week will be omitted in honor of the holiday episodes. Thank you and happy holidays.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's now time for the fabulous Price is Right pricing game recap for Wednesday, the 19th of December, 2012. Joining me tonight are my two Skype calls. First, it's Oregon representative I'm-264 Shirt. Welcome back to the pricing game recap, I'm-264 Shirt.
Yeah, thanks for having me. And it's nice to be back here, and here's wishing you a happy holiday, a Merry Christmas, and all that stuff. Season's greetings also, yeah.
And my second co-host is Canadian representative BenMasonTelevision. Welcome back to the pricing game recap once again to you too, BenMasonTelevision.
What, you were expecting somebody else?
Actually, we were. We were expecting some guy named Gary.
Yeah, Gary Newkirk.
Yeah, unfortunately, he had to cancel his appearance for tonight's pricing game recap, but...
So now you're dealing with me. Again.
Yes, we're dealing with Ben Mason.
Television. You don't mess
up. Before I begin, I just want to say, I do want to give a shout out to Newkirk G-Man 2 and hope to invite him on one of my pricing game recaps real soon. And now... it's time to go with the recap.
Go, ho, ho, ho.
Here are the pricing games that were played today. Bonkers, one wrong price, let them roll, make your move, pocket change, and secret X. Debbie, spelled D-E-B-B-Y, was the first contestant. She played Bonkers for a chance to win a trip to Finland that included a six-night stay in a Lux Room at the four-star city hotel that includes a daily breakfast and dinners, plus a visit to Santa Claus Village, modeled by the radical Rob Wilson.
I've been there. God!
They've cut it out. Seriously.
All right. The wrong price was $6,764. When the 30 seconds began, Debbie placed the disc this pattern. Higher, lower, lower, higher. And when she pressed the button, with 26 seconds left, she got it! She won on her very first try! How about that? Well, we didn't know what the price of the trip was, but it didn't matter. Debbie started off the show in a winning way.
Wow.
Yes.
Wow.
All right, I'm 264 Shirt. As this is the time of year where people should not feel blue, please tell us now about pricing game number two.
Well, Debbie's certainly not going to be feeling blue. It's going to be a holly jolly Christmas for Debbie. All right. Andrew, our second contestant on stage, played one wrong price for an iMac desktop with printer, modeled by Manuela Arbelaez, I believe that's how her name is pronounced, and marked $2,149. An LG four-door stainless steel refrigerator freezer, well, actually two doors and four drawers, modeled by the pregnant Rachel Reynolds, or should I say Audrey Hepburn. She wore her hair in a pot.
Oh my God. Breakfast at Tiffany's.
Oh, not there. Well, that price was marked $3,299. And finally, an Inspire Fitness home gym that I didn't quite catch in a lot of details on, even by rewinding, modeled by Rob Wilson, and marked $3,011. Andrew walked over to the refrigerator, and his friend, I think that's what that man was, approved of his choice. But we'll see. Rachel showed us the price of $3,299. That's right, you're wrong. The home gym was marked with a wrong price. Its actual price was $4,295. Now, that's a lot for a home gym.
Well, I had a feeling it was going to be the home gym. All right, Ben Mason Television, pricing game number three, if you please.
Right. Our third contestant was Darlene. She was a middle school teacher from Hammett, California. She played Let 'Em Roll for a chance to win a 2013 Sion PC modeled by Rob Wilson. It's a fabulous prize for $20,455. And Rachel modeled the three grocery items, which were a bag of Hershey's Milk Chocolate Kisses, yum.
Yum, yum.
A box of 18 Christmas cards with envelopes, and a box of 36 Ginger Family Gingerbread Cookies from Pepperidge Farm. Man, I'm so hungry, I could taste those right now. All right.
How about a whole horse?
Horse. This is not Mr. Ed. Anyway, first off, Rachel revealed the price of the Hershey's Kisses to be $3.49. Darlene believed the price of the Christmas cards were higher than $3.49, and Rachel revealed the price to be $4.99. She won herself a roll to go along with her one free roll. Now for the gingerbread cookies. Darlene believed that they were priced lower than $4.99, and Rachel revealed the price to be $6.49. Ah, it was higher, unfortunately. In Darlene's first roll, she got two cards and $2,000. Darlene decided to roll again, and in her second and final roll, she got $2,500.
At least it was more money.
Yeah. So that's what she ended up with, and that's going to go down as a consolation win.
Yes, sir.
Mr. Horgan, tell me more. What is pricing game number four?
Pricing game number four is New York City 7's favorite pricing game, Make Your Move. And it was played by Shannon, who is a pastry chef from Las Vegas. I like that little joke she told that she was rolling in the dough. Drew got a kick out of that. Anyway, she was playing for these three prizes. A barbecue grill tool set that has spatula, tongs, basting, and grill brushes, plus a digital fork with a built-in thermometer, a pair of all-weather wicker patio heaters, each of them have a 9 feet heating radius, and I'd like to point out that the grill set and the patio heaters were both modeled by Rachel. And the third prize was an outdoor kitchen island from Somerset Outdoor Living. Includes a refrigerator, side burner, three drawers, and a 30-inch gas grill modeled by Manuela. Now, Shannon placed the red marker on the two numbers for the price of the grill set at $70. Then she placed the yellow marker on the three numbers in the price of the patio heaters, $624. Then, with the green marker, she placed the four numbers for the price of the outdoor kitchen island at $9,359. Felt pretty confident on her choices, I must say. Now, the question was, did Shannon become a winner? Yes, she did! She won all three prizes, totaling $10,053. And talking about rolling in the dough at that value.
Wow!
I'm sure New York City 7 was very happy to see his favorite pricing game being won. All right.
All over.
Yes, of course. All right, I'm 264 shirt. Tis time to recap pricing game number five.
All right. Lauren, our fifth contestant on stage, whose name was spelled L-O-R-E-N and was a man, played pocket change for a Toyota Yaris LE modeled by Manuela. Sorry, scratchy throat. Lauren started out with 25 cents and can earn envelopes by correctly guessing the next number. But if he guessed wrong, the price would go up 25 cents. The first number of the price of the car was 1. The second number between 7, 5, 2, 4, or 9, Lauren guessed 7. And he was right, so that earned him another envelope. or the third number between 5, 2, 4, and 9, he picked a 5. He was wrong, and Manuela raised the price to 50 cents. Now between 2, 4, and 9, he picked 4. He got that one, so another envelope there. For the fourth number, between 2, 5, and 9, he picked a 5. 5 was not it, and Manuela raised the price to 75 cents. So the fourth number was either 2 or 9. Lauren picked the 2, and he was right, so that's another envelope. Finally, for the fifth number, between 5 and 9, he picked 9. And he was right, so we got one last envelope.
I thought it was a 5 itself.
No, I was thinking of the same thing. Oh, well, anyway, he had 25 cents already and needed 50 more cents. First envelope contained nothing.
Talk about getting coal in that stocking.
In the second envelope, there was a quarter. And now Lauren had 50 cents.
Much better.
The third envelope had inside a nickel. And now Lauren was up to 55 cents and needed 20 more. By the way, I can't drive 55.
Danny Hagar!
Okay. And I'm sorry to say that there wasn't a whole lot in that last envelope. In fact, all that it had inside was stupid little quarter!
Woo! Yeah!
By Christmas, while winning a $17,429 Toyota Yaris LE, certainly ensured that that wasn't going to be the case.
All right, Ben Mason Television, as we just have a little more business to tend, let's hear about today's pricing game that was played at the very end.
Right. Julia, a caregiver, plays Secret X for a chance to win 52 weeks of worth of groceries, dry cleaning for a year, and maid service once a month for a year, all modeled by Rachel and Manuela. It's a prize package for $6,797. Julia placed her 3X on the top right corner and had a chance to win up to 2 more X's and 2 more prizes. Rob modeled the 2 small prizes, which were a petite waffle cone maker from Chef's Choice that makes waffle cones in under a minute. Yeah, under a minute. And a Cuisinart frozen yogurt ice cream maker that makes up to 1.5 quarts of frozen dessert. Man, I'm getting hungrier and hungrier every time I describe these products. Here.
Me too.
First, the waffle cone maker. Julia believed that it was $49 and not $70. Rob revealed the price to be $70.
Uh-oh.
So, Julia had to get the price of the frozen yogurt maker correct in order to win at least one more X. She believed that it was $80 and not $60. Rob revealed the price to be $60, and the game was over.
And that was a pretty rough playing.
Yeah,
like
rough playing. Drew revealed the secret X to be on the top.
Yeah, alright.
Tough loss there.
Well, that does it for this edition. How did we do, Mr. Horgan?
Well, today we had 3 pricing games. One, they were Bonkers, Make Your Move, and Pocket Change. And we also gave away $2,500, which was won by Darlene in Let 'em Roll. Now, before I get to the MVPs and the contestant recognition contestants, Ben Mason Television, I believe you have an acknowledgement in your acknowledgement section. Can we hear
yes,
it, please?
Yes, I do, Mr. Horgan. And it involves Secret X. Today's playing has resulted in the first shutout since April 21st, 2011 in Season 39. And that was during George Gray's first permanent week on the show.
Yeah, he was just getting to be known by all us Price is Right fans.
Yeah. I wonder what Rich Fields was thinking back then.
I don't know.
On 264 shirt, do you have any acknowledgments?
Well, this one that I said earlier, it was that Rachel Reynolds wore her hair in a bun like Audrey Hepburn. And yes, yeah, you're thinking about Breakfast at Tiffany's, Ben Mason.
Or it could also be from Roman Holiday.
Well, otherwise, I don't know. But yeah, Audrey Hepburn was known for wearing her hair in a bun like that, and that's what Rachel did, at least in one wrong price. Okay.
All right. Today's MVPs of the Price is Right are Debbie, Shannon, and Warren. And the contestant recognition contestant is Darlene, for not only winning $2,500 in Let 'Em Roll, which does make a nice stocking stuffer, but also her showcase, which included a trip to Las Vegas that included a five-night stay in a luxury hotel courtesy of Vegas.com. She will get two tickets to a Cirque du Soleil show called O, plus another show. It also includes one dinner and a fine art gallery admission. That was modeled by Manuel. It also included a 15-foot Sea-Doo Speedster 150 ski boat that has a 155-horsepower engine, intelligent throttle control with customizable driving modes, and a sun pad, trailer included, modeled by Rob Wilson. Now, Darlene bid $20,000 flat on her showcase. The actual retail price was $22,311, for a difference of $2,311. Darlene won herself a grand total in cash and prizes of $26,311. Promotional consideration for tonight's Price is Right pricing game recap for the holidays is provided by the movie A Very Harold and Kumar Christmas. Very funny movie. Tomorrow for the pricing game recap for the holidays, my two co-hosts are going to be J. Van Diesel and Mitchell Hill, a.k.a. Meathead 177, returns.
And I'm not going to be here, unfortunately. I guarantee you that.
Well, of course. For tonight, I'm 264 Sir and Ben Mason Television. It has been a pleasure to have you guys on. You did a fantastic job.
The pleasure's ours, man. Ooh, baby.
Alright, well, it's time to say goodbye. For the Price is Right pricing game recap, this is Mr. Horrigan.
This is I'm 264 Shirt.
Could you show? Thank you.
This is I'm 264 Shirt.
And my name is Ben Mason Collinson. Remind you to help control the pet population. Have your pets spayed or neutered. See you tomorrow, everybody.
Everybody, have your pets spayed or neutered.
I said that first, actually.
Oh, whatever. All right. So long.
Bye.
See you tomorrow, everybody.